them, I tell them, your life is your own. Mm. If you fail, you fail alone. If you are in drugs, it's you. It's not affecting your mm-hmm. peer friends. Right. It's not affecting your parents. It's not affecting anybody. It is you. Mm-hmm. So here, these students know. They remember, I keep on telling them that life is very individual. Mm.
It's got nothing to do with the
so-and-so and everything. It has got nothing to do with your colleagues. It's you and you alone.
Mm-hmm.
So we are hoping that is going to, for the school, for both, it's going to, we are being patient.
Yeah.
The board has been meeting. The board, we meet as a board every 2 weeks. We are having a meeting. Every day, it's like now I'm waiting for, you know, when I came here, it was a rush. Eh?
Mm-hmm.
But I said, wherever they are talking about schools and all this, I cannot miss.
Yeah.
It's very, very important.
Mm-hmm.
We keep on meeting and reviewing things.
Right.
And it's very important for the board to work together.
Yeah.
And there we are. So we, life is difficult, and we all have to accept this is not easy. We all have to accept we need to live.
Yeah.
We know we just don't want to be careless and die.
And
we need also to eat, we need to move around, we need to exercise, we need to do all those things.
Yeah,
and also we need to listen to the government.
Mm-hmm.
These people are meeting the high top and people, sitting in meetings and giving us. Yeah,
pretty much important. Like she says, it's a very important point right here that, you know, there are people who are grown up enough and they can manage the kids out here. And January is coming, by the way. I mean, as teachers, psychologically, as you help out the government on this one, what are some of the things that you look at that would probably help us sail through and have our students safe and have you as teachers safe? Because the other day we were arguing this with my editorial team that, you know what, in as much as we would let go for people to travel, and you say the driver is tested, what of the other 14 or number of passengers who are joining in? I mean,
you know, for the,
as we wind up, yes,
for the testing bit, I think there has been a mix, and the government has been unable even to address it fully, because even at the onset of the pandemic, nobody tested matatu drivers, these ones that have been operating, nobody tested supermarket staffs. When they said supermarkets will be open, matatus before hotels came in, the testing of staff just started coming up when the hotels were being opened. So I think there has been a mix somewhere. But if the government wants to do it, they can. They know the numbers. Like for schools, they know the numbers that are supposed to be tested, and then what they should do is to localize the testing, but then that is not enough.
That is also a tough
task, but it's not also enough, because as you said, I can be tested today,
tomorrow,
and tomorrow
you're exposed.
I'm exposed. So the most important thing is the measures that will help control it. We might not stop it completely, but the measures, the hand washing and whatever. So
the masking,
the schools, as we sit now, as they go back to their offices, they must be looking at the water points in schools, such that at least it will be, even if it's after two classes, there is a watering point like that, and then sanitizers. I mean, for social distance,
anyway, everything is possible.
Schools.
We keep hoping for the best, and we can only hope that things are going to go back to equilibrium. If not so, then we'll be able to balance all the prospects. And, you know, we have our lives safe and the lives of every other person around us. Thank you so much, Madam Lizzie Wanyoke, who's the principal and the CEO of NIBS Technical College. It was great having you. And Mwalimu Ken Mbogo, right? Okay, thank you so much for your time. Also, we look forward to, you know, a smooth opening, and we need to see our students back to school and everyone at least get a chance to go back to work. It was great having you since morning, that is 6 a.m. in the morning, up until now. We have to say Kwaheri. We're looking forward to see you again tomorrow, same time, same place. My name is Linda Alena. Hirobi is up next with Matukio Mtambuko. Do enjoy the rest of your viewing. Thank you.